Hi to all. Today we're discussing about the standard deviation. So in previous class we discussed about the range, and today we discuss about the standard deviation. So this standard deviation concept introduced by Carl Pearson in 1893. So it is the important measure of dispersion, and this standard deviation is widely used in many statistical formulae. So this standard deviation is also called as a root mean deviation or mean error or mean square error. Okay, so this standard deviation provides accurate results. So let's check the definition. So the defined as positive square root the arithmetic mean of the square of the deviations of the given observations from their alter arithmetic mean. Okay, positive square root of the arithmetic mean of the squares of the deviations of the given observations from their arithmetic mean. Okay, so this is represented by the sigma. It's a Greek letter, so it's represented in the small sigma. So here we can calculate this standard deviation in two methods. One is the direct method, and the other one is the shortcut method. So in direct method we can calculate through the deviation taken from the actual mean, and here the deviations are taken from the assumed mean. Okay, these are the two methods to calculate standard deviation. So we check first one, how to calculate through the direct method. So here completely five steps are there. Okay, so first step is we have to find out the actual mean of the series. Okay, that means we have to find out the x bar. And second step, find out the deviation of each value from x minus x bar. So here we have to find out the each value from the mean. And the third one, square of the deviation of each value and take the total squared deviation, means x minus x bar whole square. Okay, sum of x minus x bar whole square. In the first step we have to find out the actual mean of the series, second one we have to deviation of each value from the mean, and third one we have to find out the squared deviations, and fourth one this divide the total by the number of observations. Okay, so here is sum of x minus x bar whole square and divided by n, and finally calculated through the formula. So here two formulas are there. One, sum standard deviation equals to under root sum of x minus x bar whole square by n. So another one, under root sum of x minus x bar whole square by n minus 1. So whether we calculated through the n means when number of observations more than 30, that time we are using this formula. Okay, so the number of observations are less than 30, that time we are using this one. Okay, so less than 30 we are using this formula, and it's more than 30 we are using this formula. That means here we are using the n when more than the 30 observations. So whether less than 30 observations are there, we are used n minus 1 instead of the n. Okay, so now we have to calculate the one example. So the example is, the following data are the height of the 10 students. Calculate the standard deviation. So the data like 60 60 61 62 63 63 63 64 64 70. So completely they are given 10 students height information. Okay, so here we have to take 3 columns. So one height in inches and x bar and x minus x bar whole square. So first we have to find out the what mean? Actual mean of the series. That means we have to find out the x bar. So here x bar equals to sum of x by n. So what is the total number of items? It's 630 by number of observation is 10. So we get 63. This is the actual mean of the data. It's 63. That means this 63 becomes the x bar value. Okay, so second step, we have to find out the deviation of each value from the mean. So means we have to subtract the this value from the mean value. So 60 minus 63 equals to minus 3. 60 minus 3 minus 3. 61 minus 63 minus 2. And 62 minus 63 we get minus 1. And here we get 0 and 117. Okay, so the next we have to squared all these values. So we get like 994100011 49. That means 77 is 49. Okay, so next here we can these values here we get. So here we can apply the formula. So how many number of observations are there? Only 10 observations are there. So means the formula is under root sum of x minus x bar whole square by n minus 1. Okay, under root sum of x minus x bar whole square by n minus 1. So what is the x minus x bar whole square value? 74 and number of observations 10 minus 1. So under root, so what we get? 74 by 9. Okay, so it's under root. Then we get root 8.22. okay, so when we have to remove the root value, so we get 2.86. so it is the standard deviation value. Okay, so here we can check that. So whether number of observations is less than 30, we can use the formula n minus 1, and whether more than 30, we can use the n. So here the first we can find out the actual mean value. So we get 63, and after that we are applying to the formula. So we get the standard deviation value is 2.86. So here we calculate through the shortcut method. So here the formula, standard deviation equals to under root sum of d square by n minus sum of d square by n whole square. This is the formula to shortcut method. So here we have to take the assumed mean. Okay, so in the first method we are using actual mean, but here we have to using assumed mean. Okay, so here we have to take in the same problem. So here how can we find out the assumed means? We have to take any one of the value, that means which is as a preceding number and a succeeding number. Okay, so here I am taking the 62 as assumed mean. So again we have to subtract these values from the assumed mean. 60 minus 62 minus 2, and 60 minus 62 we get minus 2, and 61 minus 62 we get minus 1. So like this we have to subtract all the values and we get so different values. So here when we have to add all the minus values means minus 2 minus 2 minus 1 means minus 5, plus the remaining values, 8 plus 2 10, 2 plus 12 13 14 15. So we get here 10 value. This is the sum of d. Okay, so the next d square means, so we have to square all these values. So we get here 84, that means sum of d square. Okay, so here now we can apply in the formula. So sum of d square value is 84 and number of observations is 10, and the sum of d value is 10 and the number of observations is 10. So under root 84 by 10 minus 10 by 10 whole square. Okay, so again here we get only 1 because this is both are cancelled, so here we get 1 whole square. Okay, so under root 84 divided 10 minus 1 whole square, and we get root 8.4 minus 1. Okay, and here finally we get root 7.4. so here we get root 7.4. so when we have to remove the root, that means we will get 2.72. it is the standard deviation value, it is the shortcut method. Okay, so the next one, coefficient of variation, and it is also called as a relative standard deviation. So what is coefficient of variation means? So when we are expressed in terms of units, okay, when we are expressed in terms of units in which the original figures are collected and stated, so through the standard deviation, so we cannot compare the two different values. Means here the length of fishes cannot be compared with the weights of fishes. So when we want to compare the values, that's time these are converted into relative measure of dispersion, which is called coefficient of variation. So when we compare the two different values, that's time the standard deviation must be converted into a measure of dispersion. So it's called coefficient of variation. So it's developed by Carl Pearson. Okay, so here the formula to find out the coefficient of variation is standard deviation by mean into 100, that is standard coefficient of variation equals to sigma by x bar into 100. So here we have to take the one example. Here we solve the one problem, so which is belongs to the example of coefficient of variation. So the example like practices of a particular commodity in 5 years, it 2 states are given below. From this data find the state which had more stable prices. So one is a price in Tamil Nadu and the one is a price in Kerala. So these are the price details from last 5 years. So here the formula to find out the coefficient of variation is standard deviation by x bar into 100. So first we find out the x bar. X bar means sum of total by number of observations. Okay, so here for here sum of total means what we get, ma? 3 plus 2 5. So here we get 100 and the number of observations 5 divided by 20. Okay, so x bar equals to 20, and here the standard deviation is 2.45. okay, so now we can apply 2.4 by 20 into 100, we get 12.25, and here the sigma standard deviation value is 3.69 and average is 15 into 100, so here we get 24.6. so means here Tamil Nadu had more stable prices than Kerala because the coefficient variance is lower in Tamil Nadu. So when we compare these two, here we get 24.6 and here 12.25. this is the lowest values are present in the Tamil Nadu. Okay, so it's about the coefficient of variation. So it is useful for the compare the two different values. Thank you.